Good morning, everyone. We have started with the new chapter, that is kinematic flow in fluid mechanics, and we have also started with the first numerical related to velocity and acceleration. We have discussed about the formula for velocity potential, which is equals to ui plus vj plus wk, and if you need to find out the resultant, that is given by under root of u square plus v square plus w square. Okay, similarly we have also got the formula for acceleration, ax, ay and az. Based on this formula is we need to calculate what the velocity component as well as your acceleration components. So we have started with the first numerical. This numerical we have started. We'll do the next numerical. So the second numerical, it is saying that the following case represent two velocity component. Determine the third component of velocity such that they satisfy the continuity equation. So there are basically two cases. The first case is, it has been given that they are having only two components. That is, first one is your u component, that represent x coordinate. U equals to what? X square plus y square plus z square. And v represent your y coordinate, which is equals to what? X y square minus y z square plus x y. So we'll do it one by one. The continuity equation for incompressible fluid, as we have seen the derivation for continuity equation for three-dimensional flow, the continuity equation was this. So this was the continuity equation, and for the incompressible fluid, the final equation was del u by del x plus del v by del y plus del w by del z. So we need to use this equation, okay, and we'll try to solve this. Okay, this is the continuity equation, del u by del x plus del v by del y plus del w by del z equals to 0. Okay, so for the case 1, we need to consider the first part, that is u equals to what? X square plus y square plus z square, and v equals to what? X y square minus y z square plus x y. So basically u represent your x component, so we will write del u by del x. So if we derivate this component with respect to x direction, so as you can see there is only one x component, so it will become 2x. The derivative of x square becomes 2x, and y is constant and z is constant, that will be equal to 0. So del u by del x equals to what? 2x. Okay, then if we derivate this component with respect to y, del u by del y, so this will become what? 2xy minus z square plus x. Okay, so this y will become 1, this y will become 1, and this y square will become 2xy. So this is the derivative. So this is the u component, this is the v component. Now we'll put this components in the continuity equation. So del u by del x represent 2x, del v by del y represent what? 2xy minus z square plus x. And del w by del z, we need to calculate this. So we will keep dw by dz on the left hand side and all the other components on the right hand side. So it will become what? 2x plus x become 3x, so minus 3x. Okay, then minus 2xy, then plus z square. So this is the final equation. Dw equals to what? Minus 3x plus minus 2xy plus z square into what? Del z. So in order to get the W component, we need to integrate this value so that we can get the third component, that is W. So integration of dW on the left hand side and dW on the right hand side with respect to what? Z. So this will become what? W. And if we integrate this with respect to Z, so integration of a constant becomes what? Z. So minus 3xz. And again, this is also constant, so minus 2xyz, and z square, integration of z square is what? Z cube by 3 plus the constant of integration. So this is the third component. Okay, after that, in case 2, we need to consider the equation. The equation is what? V equals to what? 2y square and W equals to what? 2xyz. So V equals to what? 2y square and W equals to what? 2xyz. Here the missing term is your u, so we need to find out the u component. So derivative of V component represent y direction, W component represent z direction. So we need to derivate this with respect to y and this component with respect to z. So del v by del y of this will become what? Y square will become 2y, and there is already 2, that will multiply by 2. This will give you 4y. After that, this one is what? Derivative of W with respect to Z. So there is only one Z component, that will become 1. So this will equal to 2XY. So this is the del V by del Y equals to what? 4Y, and del W by del Z equals to what? 2XY. Now we will put these component into your continuity equation. So the continuity equation is del U by del X, del U by del X, and we will put del V by del Y the value, and del W by del Z the value. So del u by del x is unknown, and del v by del y is coming out to be 4y, and del w by del z equals to what? 2xy. Now we'll keep del u by del x on the left hand side and all the other components on the right hand side. So this will all become minus 4y minus 2xy. Again we'll take the x component on the right hand side, so del u by minus 4y minus 2xy into del x. And now if you want to find out the u component, we need to integrate this. So integration of this with respect to x. So here there is no x component. So minus 4y, it will be, there will be one x component. So minus 4xy minus 2x square by 2. And y is already over there. Okay. Plus fyz, this is your constant. So this is the final equation. After that, we will see the next numerical. The second problem, it says that a fluid flow field in a given is given by V equals to what? X square y I plus y square z j minus 2xyz plus yz square into k. Prove that it is a case of possible steady incompressible flow. We need to prove that whether the steady flow is there is or not. And then also calculate the velocity and acceleration component. So we need to also calculate the velocity and acceleration component. So first, in order to find whether it is a case of a steady flow or not, we need to justify whether it is following the continuity equation or not. So we'll first write the component u equals to what? X square y, and v component is what? Y square z, and z component is what? W equals to what? Minus 2xy. This will, after opening this bracket, this will be minus 2xyz and minus yz square. Okay, so because the continuity equation is what? Del u by del x plus del v by del y and del w by del z. So we need to find out this value to derivate this equation with respect to what? X. So that will become what? 2xy. And if we derivate this with respect to y, this will be what? 2yz. And if we derivate this equation with respect to z, that will be equal to what? 2xy. Okay, minus 2yz. So this is the derivative form of x, y, and z. We'll try to put all this in the continuity equation. So after substituting all this value, we get what? 2xy plus 2yz, then minus 2xy. And minus 2yz. So here you can see that this is positive 2xy, this is negative 2xy. So this will get cancelled. Then this is positive 2yz and negative 2yz. This will also get cancelled. That is why it is coming out to be 0. That means it is following the continuity equation. So it is a case of what? Steady incompressible fluid flow. Okay, so that was needed. It was saying that we need to prove that whether it is a case of possible steady flow. So if it is following the continuity equation, then it is a case of steady incompressible fluid flow. Okay, so as you can see, the value of continuity equation is coming out to be 0. So it is proved now that it is a case of possible fluid flow. Okay, after that the question is also saying that we need to calculate what velocity and acceleration components. So the coordinates are also given, x coordinate is what, 2, y coordinate is 1 and z coordinate is 3. So we'll put the velocity, substituting the velocity value, velocity component value, x equals to 2, y equals to 1 and z equals to 1. So this is the velocity component equation, x square yi plus y square zj minus 2xyz plus 2 plus yz square k. So we'll put, instead of x we'll put 2, instead of y we'll put 1, and instead of z we'll put your 3. So 2 square into 1 I plus 1 square into 3 minus what, 2 into in place of x it is 2, y we'll put 1, and in place of z 3. So after putting all this value, the final equation which is coming out, it is 4i plus 3j minus 21k. So if we need to find out the resultant velocity, we need to use this formula, 4 square plus 3 square minus 21 square. So the final value which is coming out to be the velocity component is 21.587 unit. Now it is also saying that we need to calculate the acceleration component. So the acceleration component formula for ax is this formula, ay is this formula, az is this formula. So we will try to what, find out this value. So we need to what, derivate u with respect to what, x. So if we derivate this equation, u equals to what, x square into y, with respect to x we get what, 2xy. Okay, after that del u by del y, again we need to integrate this value with respect to y, so x will be constant, so that will be equal to what, x square, and y equals to what, 1. After that similarly again we need to derivate u with respect to z, so there is no z component, there is only x and y, so it will become directly 0. After that we need to derivate y square z with respect to what, x, so there is no x component, so it will become 0. Again we need to derivate this with respect to what, y, that will be equals to 2y into z, and again we need to derivate this with respect to z, so there is a single component of z, that will be equals to 1, so it will be left with only y square. So this is the derivative form of u, v and w. So we will put all this value. Okay, this is for v and the last one is for w. So the final value for w was what, minus 2xyz minus y square z. So we will derivate it with respect to first x, so there is only one x component, so it will be left with what, minus 2yz, and here there is no x component, it will become 0. Derivate this equation again with respect to what, y, so there is only one y component, it will be left with minus 2xz. Okay, here the y component is there, so it will be left with minus z square. Then again this will be derivative with respect to what, z, so there is only one z component, it will be left with minus 2xy, and here is also yz square, so it will become 2yz. This will be both minus because the sign in front of them is only minus. So this is the value for u, this is the value for v, this is the value for w. Now we need to calculate the acceleration for x, acceleration coordinate for y, acceleration coordinate for z. So we'll put all these values, substitute all this value in that. So u value is what, x square y. Okay, del u by del z value is coming out to be what, 2xy, we'll put 2xy in there. After that v, that is y square z, and then del u by del y is coming out to be what, x square, so we'll put x square. Then w minus 2xyz plus yz square into what, del u by del z was coming out to be 0. Okay, after solving this we get this equation, and after putting the x and component as 2, y component as 1 and z component as 3, the final equation we get is what, the final value which is coming out is 28 units. Similarly, in case of y, we'll put the same u, again x square y, del v by del x was coming out to be 0. This is coming out to be 0, so this will also become 0. Then v component is what? Y square z into del v by del y. Del v by del y is coming out to be 2yz. We have put in this 2yz. Now w is minus 2xyz plus yz square, and del v by del z was coming out to be y square, so we'll put y square over here. So after solving this and putting the coordinates value, we are getting the final answer is minus 3 units. Okay, similarly for z, we'll put the value for z. So for z, first we'll put the u value. U value is coming out to be what? X square y into what? Del w by del x. So del w by del x was coming out to be minus 2yz. So x square y minus 2yz. After that, plus v value is what? Y square z. And del w by del y, the value for del w by del y is minus 2xz. So we'll put minus y square z minus 2xz minus z square. And similarly for w, the value is what? Minus 2xyz plus yz square into the value for what? Dw by dz. So the value for dw by dz is minus 2xy minus 2yz. So this is the equation for your az acceleration. After solving this equation and putting the coordinates x equals to 2, y equals to 1, and z equals to 3, we get the final value for acceleration in z direction equals to 123. So the final equation for acceleration is 28i minus 3j plus 123k. So if we need to calculate the resultant acceleration will be what? Under root of what? Your ax plus ay plus az. So ax value is 28 square, ay value is minus 3 square, and z value is what? 123 square. So after solving this, we get the final answer as 126.18 unit.